This is what trauma is for a lot of people.
Carl, get inside the house, Carl.
You feel like your world is safe, something terrible happens, and now the world is unsafe.
No!
Almost every time a trauma happens, you feel like something happened that was outside of your control.
Daddy's got you.
And that made you feel unsafe, that made you feel scared, that made you feel panicked, and we don't like to feel those things.
NEMO! No!
And so what do? We try and control our environments, and we try and control other people so that we can control the outcomes so we can feel safe.
How do you know something bad isn't gonna happen?
I don't!
So what's the difference between helicopter parenting and just parenting? Let's find out.
Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Alan Seawright, a professional filmmaker who needs therapy. I'm joined by...
Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. What's going on, man?
I'd like to have you react to a fish. Piranha. A movie about a fish.
Piranha 3D.
You little ginger moron.
Piranha 2, James Cameron's first movie.
Really?
He is disavowed.
What are we actually watching, though?
We're actually watching Finding Nemo, because
oh,
I want
nice.
To talk about daddy issues and daddy issues.
Okay. Helicopter parenting, I'm assuming, because, man, is all over this story.
Helicopter parenting? Cults?
Cults?
Wahoo ha hee ha.
Oh, yeah. Oh, oh, yeah. Oh.
You have been called forth to the summit of Mount Wanahakalugi.
Wake up!
Hi, Nemo.
I don't want to go to school. 5 more minutes.
Not you, Dad. Me.
Okay.
Get up! Huh? Get up! Time for school! Time for school! Time for school! Time for school!
All right, I'm up.
Boy,
it's time
oh boy,
for school.
Oh boy! Whoa!
Nemo!
Where's
Nemo, don't move! You'll never get out of there yourself. I'll do it. All right, where's the brake? You feel a brake?
No.
Sometimes you can't tell because fluid is rushing into the area. Now, any rushing fluids?
No.
Are you woozy?
No.
How many stripes do I have?
I'm fine.
Answer the stripe question.
3.
No! See, something's wrong with you. I have 1, 2, 3. That's all I have? Oh, you're okay. How's the lucky fin?
Lucky.
Let's see. Are you sure you want to go to school this year? Because there's no problem if you don't. You can wait 5 or 6 years.
Come on, Dad. Time for school.
Forgot to brush.
Oh.
Do you want this anemone to sting you?
Yes.
Brush.
Okay, I'm done.
Up, you missed a spot.
Where?
There. Right there. And here, and here.
And this is why Finding Nemo is another Pixar perfect picture.
America, yeah.
If you can establish a story beat...
Yeah.
Good job. You just did some exposition. If you can establish a story beat while telling you things about the character, while also establishing other story beats that the audience doesn't realize you're establishing, that's actually good writing.
Because none of this feels like exposition. It feels like this. Here's how you know it's exposition. It doesn't feel like a conversation actual people would have.
As you know,
yeah.
We have to get the nuclear codes to the launch facility.
Right?
It's like, I know this. Why are you telling me? Because the audience doesn't know, as you know.
Right, right. And it's always so sloppy. And here, you learn that Marlin is very overprotective through a very natural moment of Nemo slipping out. And then Nemo
and then
is...
Marlin overreacting.
Right? You see Marlin has anxiety, but you also see how much love he has for his son
yes.
with the playful moment and how much Nemo loves him back. Like, it's all just right there. And no one has to say, I love you, son.
Right.
So why is Marlin so overprotective? Well, we see in the prologue
yes.
that he loses his wife and most of his children to a barracuda.
Do you know the story about the prologue?
Mm-mm.
It didn't used to be a prologue. When they first wrote the movie and did their first animatics, so they, you know, draw storyboards and put it all together with, like, temporary voice actors and stuff, that happened as a flashback later in the film. They moved it to the very front of the movie because... You go through this entire movie with this nebbishy, like, overprotective helicopter parenting guy, and nobody liked him.
Yeah.
And they realized they didn't have to change anything, they didn't have to do anything. All they had to do was pick up one scene that already existed and just move it. And it gives you context for why he is the way he is. And everyone loves Marlin from top to bottom because it's like, I get why he is this
yeah. way. Yeah. And this is part of... filmmaking is how do you structure the story is
yes.
everything. Because you can have the same, like you're saying, you have the same story beats, same writing, same performances, but where is it in the story structure makes a huge difference.
Huge difference.
All right.
This week's episode is brought to you by Mended Light, my online trauma clinic. Many of you, like Marlin, feel like your world is no longer safe because of loss, tragedy, and trauma. Maybe you used to feel confident, but now you live with fear, anxiety, and a need to control your life. Maybe you don't know who or how to trust. Perhaps it's hard to function at school or at work or in social situations, and it's hard to believe that things are ever going to get better. Maybe you even feel worthless and like whatever light you had inside is going out. If any of what I've just mentioned describes you, we've got a proven system that has helped thousands of people to heal and thrive again, and I believe that it can help you. Our innate healing program offers trauma recovery tools and support through a combination of online courses and one-on-one work with a member of our clinical team. Our trauma recovery specialists all have advanced degrees in fields like psychology, family therapy, and trauma recovery. I've handpicked every one of them and trained them in our trauma recovery program. They are experienced and skilled and will guide you step by step from fear to courage, from anxiety to personal power, from darkness to inner light. They will also guide you through our Relationship Foundations program, a series of online courses in which I teach you all of the conflict resolution, communication, and connection skills that I've taught thousands of people in therapy. We also have an online membership site with new courses, live Q&As, and a virtual book club with Alicia and I to help you with your self-guided support. It's time to step out of the darkness and into the light. It's time to get the support you need. It's time to replace fear with peace. Go to mendedlight.com/CT and schedule an 80-minute first session with a member of our clinical team today.
Dad, maybe while I'm at school, I'll see a shark.
I highly doubt that.
I just wanted to include this because...
No, and I don't plan to.
How old are sea turtles?
Sea turtles? I don't know.
Cindy Plankton from next door, he says that...
This just sounds like a kid sort of... random, you know, stream of consciousness asking questions, and Nemo is laying out the entire plot of the movie.
Yes.
Okay.
I know you're a sucker for just a tight,
yes,
perfect screenplay, and this is one of those.
This is one of those. Edgar Wright, Simon Pegg movies are famous for this, mm-hmm. Like the scene in Shaun of the Dead where they're sitting at the bar, and Ed lays out the entire plot of the movie.
We'll have a Bloody Mary first thing. Have a bite of the King's Head, couple of the Little Princess, we'll stagger back in. Back at the bar for Sean's. How's that for a slice of fried gold?
And then it literally beat for beat is just that afterwards,
yeah.
But it's just two bros joking around.
And this does a similar thing to Edgar Wright's movies where even the jokes that feel like throwaway gags are either character building or they're actually setting up something later that's either
oftentimes
emotional.
Both.
Yeah. It's either setting up an emotional moment or another joke later on, but there's like everything has a purpose.
It's serving three purposes at once.
Yeah.
Well done, Pixar. Well done.
Come on, Nemo, how far can you go?
My dad says it's not safe.
Nemo, no!
Dad?
Ugh, you're about to swim into open water.
No, I wasn't going
to. It's just a good thing I was here.
Dad,
if I hadn't shown up,
sorry,
I don't know.
He wasn't going to go.
Yeah, he was too afraid.
No, I wasn't.
This does not concern you, kids.
And Marlon's not listening.
Your parents, you were out there. You know you can't swim well.
I can swim fine, Dad, okay?
No, it's not okay.
Tell him what he can and can't do.
Okay, I was right. You know what? We'll start school in a year or two.
No, Dad! Just because you're scared of the ocean...
Clearly you're not ready, and you're not coming back here till you are. You think you can do these things, but you just can't, Nemo!
I hate you.
There's nothing to see. Gather! Oh, over there. Excuse me, is there anything I can do? I am a scientist, sir. Is there any problem?
He isn't a good swimmer, and... I just think it's a little too soon for him to be out here unsupervised.
Well, I can assure you he's quite safe with me.
Look, I'm sure he is. But you have a large class, and he can get lost, you know, from sight if you're not looking. Now, I'm not saying you're not looking.
Oh, my gosh! Nemo's swimming out the sea!
So Marlin assumes.
Yeah.
He assumes Nemo's swimming out when Nemo's not. Then he doesn't listen. And then he controls. And then he's surprised when Nemo says, I hate you. Now, this is what helicopter parenting is, and it comes from a good place. It comes mm-hmm. from, I love you, I care about you, I want you to stay safe. But because of that opening scene, we see...
It's very sympathetic.
Yeah, that it comes from a place of real trauma and real loss. And I think helicopter parenting comes from either first-person experience, I've experienced a trauma so I don't want my kids to, or secondhand of someone you know, or frankly, just living in the world we live in and reading or watching the news.
Yes.
So what's the difference between helicopter parenting and just parenting? I don't know. Let's find out.
The extent.
The extent. Yeah, because you do have to provide structure and you do need to protect. But I guess it's the control aspect. It's the not listening and it's the making assumptions. That is the real problem here.
Sure.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay, let's go.
No, no, bad trench, bad trench. Come on, we're gonna swim over this thing.
Whoa, whoa, partner. Little red flag going up. Something's telling me we should swim through it, not over it.
Are you even looking at this thing? It's got death written all over it.
I'm sorry, but I really, really, really think we should swim through.
And I'm really, really done talking about this. Over we go.
Come on, trust me on this.
Trust you.
Yes, trust. It's what friends do.
Look, something shiny.
Where?
Oh, it just swam over the trench. Come on, we'll follow it.
Okay.
We control when, especially as a trauma response, as a coping response to trauma, almost every time a trauma happens, you feel like something happened that was outside of your control.
Right.
Or things happened. And that made you feel unsafe. That made you feel scared. That made you feel panicked. And we don't like to feel those things. And so what do? We try and control our environments and we try and control other people so that we can control the outcomes so we can feel safe.
They're schemers. Schemers trying to control their little worlds.
And of course, control is an illusion.
Sure, yeah. Yeah. You're not in control of anything, sorry.
No, literally the only thing you can control is yourself. That's it. Mm-hmm. But Marlin thinks that he has to manage everything in order to keep the fish that he cares about safe. In this case, that extends to Dory. Yeah. He does care about her, but he's like, I don't trust you with you. Let me take care of you. And,
right.
And he does the same thing with his son and pushes his son away. And he's going to end up pushing Dory away for a similar reason. We have to learn to extend trust. And when we don't think someone's making the right call, we can only make a choice for us. Because he could have just said, look, you can swim through it. I'm going to choose to swim over it. That wouldn't have been trusting in his friend, but it also wouldn't have been deceitful, which is what he did.
Right.
When he took advantage of her mental condition to trick her. Which is a great joke, but a real move.
Yeah. Exactly.
Oh my goodness!
Whoa, kill the motor, dude. Let us see what Squirt does flying solo.
Whoa! That was so cool! Hey, Dad, did you see that? Did you see me? Did you see what I did?
You so totally rock, Squirt! Missing Finn. Logan. Dude. Oh, intro. Jellyman, offspring. Offspring, Jellyman.
Jellies? Sweet.
Totally.
Well, apparently I must have done something you all liked. Dudes.
You rock, dude.
Ow.
Curl away, my son. Oh, it's awesome, Jellyman. Little dudes are just eggs. We leave them on the beach to hatch, and then coo-coo-ca-choo, they find their way back to the big old blue.
All by themselves?
Sure.
But dude, how do you know when they're ready?
Well, you never really know, but when they know, you'll know, you know? Oh.
So I love that he learns from Crush a whole different style of parenting.
Like the complete opposite of helicopter parenting, which is literally just like, yeah, we just drop off some eggs.
Yeah. And so Crush, you see his son like fall out of the EAC and Marlin's like, oh no. And I love that Crush says, let us see
how he does.
How he does solo. And I love Crush's style of parenting is not to say I don't care. He is right there.
Yeah.
Because if his son doesn't do it, he's not going to let him die.
Right.
Because he wants his son to have the accomplishment of, I worked my way back in.
Yes.
Right? And he's so excited. Dad, I did it. Did you see me? And his dad's so proud of him and so affirming. And Marlin hasn't had faith in Nemo.
Right.
Hey, psst. Oh, Nigel, you just missed an extraction.
Oh, has he loosened the periodontal ligament with the elevator yet?
What am I talking about?
I love Nemo. The weird details that Pixar always puts in.
What is it?
Your dad's been fighting the entire ocean looking for you.
My father? Really?
Oh, yeah. He's traveled hundreds of miles. He's been battling sharks and jellyfish,
sharks?
All sorts of...
That can't be him.
And then a couple of seconds later, he's like, that is my dad.
Yeah.
But just, you know, his first instinct when he hears something scary happen is, oh, that can't be my dad. He's too scared of everything.
Yeah. But, you know, love makes us challenge our fears. That's the beauty of Marlin's growth. At the beginning, he doesn't have a lot of fear. This is what trauma is for a lot of people. Mm. You feel like your world is safe. Something terrible happens, and now the world is unsafe. And you approach everything and everyone with caution and trepidation. And Marlin gets to this place of, yeah, the world is messed up and dangerous, but that doesn't mean I'm incapable of facing it.
Right.
Right? And I don't need to hide from it just because it hurts and it's scary. So Marlin is growing as a fish, also growing as a parent. What he learned from Crush and now what he learns from Dory is going to get him to where he needs to be.
Okay, let's see.
Hey. You okay? There. It's all right. It'll be okay.
No, it won't.
Sure it will. You'll see.
No. I promised him I'd never let anything happen to him.
That's a funny thing to promise.
What?
Well, you can't never let anything happen to him. Then nothing would ever happen to him. Not much fun for little Harpo.
Parents who do everything for their kids create kids who are incapacitated for adulthood.
Yep.
If you don't let anything happen to them, nothing will ever happen to them. You can't protect them from heartache.
No.
From danger. You can't protect them from sadness. You can't protect them from... And you wish you could.
Sure.
Because you see them in pain and it hurts you. And then you realize, to a certain extent, pain helps them become who they need to be and hardship helps them. And your job is just to prepare, right?
Yep.
It's to prepare, it's to be there, it's to support, much like Crush is. It's to encourage, it's to instruct, and it's to honor free will.
Yeah.
And Marlon's not been doing that.
You can get Internet Dad's popcorn on our website, ctpopcorn.com.
It's corny.
It's super corny. This looks like the ocean, but it tastes like blueberry cheesecake.
ctpopcorn.com. Get your popcorn.
It's corny.
Oh.
My entire parenting philosophy is to set my kids up for a million failures and always be there to comfort them.
Yeah.
Because the more they fail, the more they're going to learn. And as long as they know that they can fail and be safe and be loved, that's the most important thing you can learn in life. Because we fail all the time. Yeah. I'm constantly failing. I'm failing right now. I'm failing at providing any insight into the filmmaking of this movie.
No. Well, you had something you were telling about the research that went into this.
Oh, yeah. No, just one of the things I love about Pixar is they always do an insane amount of research. And in this, in order to really get the feel of being fish, all of the animators actually put on fish costumes and then went down to the local pool and just swam around.
No, they didn't.
You're right. I made all of that up. This whole channel is bullshit.
Okay.
Dory!
He says it's time to let go. Everything's gonna
metaphor.
Be all right.
How do you know? How do you know something bad isn't gonna happen? We're alive!
And we get stuck sometimes and we hold on to things that we know aren't good, but at least they're known.
Yeah.
And so he's like, how do you know something bad is not going to happen? I don't. But we could just stay stuck inside of a whale, which
is also not good.
Right. And how many... We stay in abusive relationships, or we stay in situations that are bad for us because we don't know what's going to happen if we let go.
Right.
But Dory's point is very profound, but we do know what's going to happen if we hold on.
Right.
And we got to make that choice. Also, you can't hold fin to fin like that. You need digits.
True. I don't know much about whale tongues, but that's all I'm going to say.
Okay, that wasn't even what I was talking about.
This whole channel is bullshit.
Hey.
Dory, if it wasn't for you, I never would have even made it here. So thank you.
So for those of you who haven't seen...
Hey, wait a minute.
Why? But also...
Wait, where are you going?
It's over, Dory.
He thinks Nemo's dead.
Too late. Nemo's gone. And I'm going home now.
No. No, you can't. Stop! Please don't go away. Please. No one's ever stuck with me for so long before. And if you leave, I remember things better with you. I do. Look, P. Sherman, 42. I remember it. I do. It's there. I know it is, because when I look at you, I can feel it. And I look at you and I'm home. I don't want that to go away. I don't want to forget.
I'm sorry, Dory. But I do.
Gosh dang it, Pixar.
And that's what Pixar does so masterfully, is it doesn't matter how silly the story is. What matters is the emotional truth of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we've all had that. When I look at you, I'm home. Whoever that person is in your life, like, we feel that.
Yeah.
And for Marlin, that was Nemo. And that's why he wants to forget. Again, not a wasted line. Not a wasted second. It's all just... Even the spaces of silence are perfectly measured.
They're perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Folks, we have a lot of extra bonus content over on our Patreon, including an extended director's cut and commercial-free director's cut. Skits and behind the scenes footage and all sorts of stuff that we create just for our patrons. Go to patreon.com/cinematherapy.
Oh, hey, look out!
I'm sorry, just trying to get home. Nemo?
Yay!
Nemo?
Yay! Nemo for what?
Dory? Nemo!
Yay!
Nemo! I'm coming, Nemo! It's all right, son. It's gonna be okay.
Turn around! You're coming the wrong way!
And then the moment we've all been waiting for lasts about 3 seconds.
3 seconds. Like, oh, good. That's great storytelling. Hurt your heroes. Take away what they love.
Well, because the arc isn't finished yet.
Uh-oh.
Because we think the story's been building to their reunion, but it's actually been building to this.
Dory!
Come on! Help! Dory! Dad, it's
out! No! Dory!
Dad, I know what to do!
Nemo, no!
We have to tell all the fish to swim down together!
Get out of there now!
I know this will work!
No, I am not going to lose you again!
Dad, there's no time! It's the only way we can save Dory! I can do this!
You're right. I know you can.
Look at Finn!
Go! Hurry!
Tell all the fish to swim down!
Well, you heard my son? Come on!
So Nemo had his own arc through the story, which is his dad taught him not to believe in himself and that he couldn't figure things out or do things, but then he learned that he could. And the only reason Nemo's taking action now is because he's like, I can do this. I know I can.
I've done it before. And Marlin has grown, not because of spending time with Nemo, but honestly because of spending time with Dory.
Yeah. That he needs to trust other fish.
Especially his son. Not much fun for little Harpo.
Just keep swimming!
Just keep swimming. Again, all the seeds.
Everything is a seed that was planted, and it grows into a gorgeous tree of storytelling.
Payoff.
That's
a payoff tree. Honestly, if fish could organize in real life,
we'd be screwed.
Yeah.
That's my dad.
Come on, let's get to the bottom. Keep swimming.
Just keep swimming. Just keep swimming.
Keep swimming.
And I just the accuracy of physics, mm-hmm. that what breaks is what would actually break. Yeah. It's not the line, it's not the...
There!
Oh, no. Of course, a moment of triumph, take it away.
Nemo? Nemo? It's okay. Daddy's here. Daddy's got you.
Perfectly timed little flashback.
Daddy?
Oh, thank goodness.
Dad, I don't hate you.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm so sorry, Nemo.
And Nemo's wanted to take back that I hate you the whole movie.
Hey, guess what?
What?
Sea turtles? I met one. And he was 150 years old.
150?
Yep.
Because Sandy Plankton said they only lived to be 100.
Sandy Plankton? Do you think I would cross the entire ocean and not know as much as Sandy Plankton? He was 150, not 100.
A freaking masterpiece. Kids are going to grow up.
Yeah.
Or they won't if you don't let them.
Kids are going to grow up. You hope.
Yeah. And you have to trust them.
Yeah.
Yes, age-appropriate choices. Like,
sure.
My 7-year-old says, Dad, can I drive? I'm sorry. No. But they need to learn to make their own decisions, and they need to learn to have confidence in themselves so that they can face the world. Mm-hmm. And your job isn't to protect them, it's to raise them.
That's right. And this movie is a perfectly constructed screenplay. For the time, the CG was absolutely mind-blowing. Honestly, a little bit dated looking now, but mm-hmm. the animation is so good that it's still very watchable.
Yeah.
So all of the character performances are still really great. It's just you look at this compared with, you know, the way Finding Dory looks, whatever that was 15 years later.
Yeah.
They were going for hyper-real, and what they ended up with was a plastic ocean full of weird little speckles.
Yeah, the environment still look...
It looks beautiful. The art design is fantastic.
Yeah.
The processing power wasn't there.
Yeah, and that's just technology.
And that's just technology. But the thing that is great about it is it doesn't matter. Because it's an animated movie... Doesn't matter. This is still just as watchable. It's 20 years old. We're yeah. very old now.
Bye!
Hold on, here we go! Next up, knowledge!
Bye, son! Have fun!
Bye, Dad! Oh, Mr. A? Wait, I forgot something! Love you, Dad.
I love you too, son.
So I praise subtlety in filmmaking all the time because...
Sorry. Now go have an adventure.
Goodbye.
Telling a story subtly is harder...
Nemo.
Nemo! Bye, Nemo!
...than punching you in the face with it. But the hardest thing... Do you remember this from our RRR episode?
Bye, son.
The hardest thing to do in filmmaking and make it work is be obvious and so good that it doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
Go have an adventure. Bye, son.
Yeah. Yeah.
F***ing learned it.
I think it still comes down to what we were talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
At least in this case, not making it feel like exposition, but like something he would actually say.
It feels earned and real and believable for the character, even though it's exactly like the cherry on top, perfect, wrapped in a bow yeah. gift that you want at the end of the movie. It doesn't feel that way. It feels real.
And we are here for it because the film put in the work.
Shut up! You rats with wings!
The bloke's been looking for his boy Nemo.
Nemo?
He was taken off the reef by divers and this...
There, take it, you happy! Hey, say that again. You just said something about Nemo. What was it?
Mine!